Plastic waste from electrical and electronic equipment can contain up to 20% in additives such as brominated flame retardants and antimony trioxide. Recycling plastic waste from electrical and electronic equipment is very challenging because some of those brominated flame retardants are toxic. Each year, Europe produces up to 1.2 million tons of this type of plastic waste. And currently, no suitable commercial recycling technology is available. And about 70% of this type of plastic waste is exported from the European Union to other countries. There, the waste is treated, but this can result in hazardous incineration, illegal forms of landfill, which means that hazardous substances can end up in the environment, and uncontrolled recycling into new plastics that contain hazardous substances. Meanwhile, this type of plastic waste is one of the fastest growing streams of municipal waste, so the negative impact on health and the environment is also increasing rapidly. This means that we urgently need an economically viable and sustainable technological method of recycling these types of plastics. For this reason, TNO coordinates the Plast2bcleaned project. The focus is on plastics that are commonly used in electrical and electronic equipment, such as refrigerators, computers, and mobile phones. Since these plastics may contain so-called legacy additives, additives which were allowed in past but are now banned, recycling them is challenging. The project is working on a number of new technologies. 1. Pre-processing to sort and separate the different types of polystyrenes. 2. Dissolution in superheated solvents of polystyrene fractions containing brominated flame retardants. 3. Separating the additives to collect the bromine and antimony fractions and to remove other unwanted additives from the polymer. And finally, recovering the polymer and recycling the solvent. These new technologies will help to close 3 recycling loops: the loops for polymer, bromine, and antimony trioxide. Here at the TNO laboratory, we are investigating recycling by dissolution in solvents. Our technology is based on the use of a low boiling solvent at an elevated temperature in order to help the polymers to dissolve. The hot polymer solution has a sufficiently low viscosity to allow for the use of conventional separation techniques, such as filtration and adsorption, which remove the additives and impurities present in the plastics. The polymer can then be recovered and the bromine fraction and antimony fraction can be collected. The aim of Plast2bcleaned is to develop technologies that can easily be adapted for use in similar waste streams for other sectors, such as the automotive industry, construction and infrastructure, the packaging industry. In the next stage of the project team will take the technique out of the laboratory and scale it up in a pilot plant, which will produce 50 kilograms of polymer samples. The composition and properties of the recycled polymer can then be assessed, an important aspect in determining whether they can be reused in electronic goods. The recovered material will be demonstrated in an electronic product such as a refrigerator or a washing machine. We are also in the process of a detailed economic and environmental assessment. Initial results show that the techniques developed could be economically viable and are more environmentally sustainable than current treatments. If you would like to know more, please visit plast2bcleaned.eu or tno.nl/plastics.